When President Obama presented the Medal of Honor to Staff Sergeant Ty Carter, he not only heralded Carter's heroism on the battlefield at Combat Outpost Keating during one of the deadliest attacks in Afghanistan.
It was chaos, the blizzard of bullets and steel into which Ty ran, not once or twice or even a few times, but perhaps 10 times. And in doing so, he displayed the essence of true heroism.
He pointed out that Carter has made it his mission to destigmatize the post-traumatic stress that hundreds of thousands of U.S. troops and veterans are dealing with.
Ty has spoken openly, with honesty and extraordinary eloquence, about his struggle with post-traumatic stress.
Carter was once a skeptic of what he calls PTS. He doesn't want the D. He says it's not a disorder.
I didn't believe it was real until I experienced it. I thought it was just an excuse to get out of duty or not do a job. But once it hit me and I realized it, I was blown away. How could I be so ignorant?
No longer. During the horrific battle at Combat Outpost Keating, an enemy RPG explosion caused Carter to lose some hearing.
Ever since that day, I've had this high-pitched ringing in my ears.
In the dark, quiet moments, the constant ringing in his head brings him back to the battle. Since he left the outpost, Carter has been receiving regular treatment for post-traumatic stress. It's a treatment that is allowing him to continue his career path in the Army. Someone not so fortunate was one of Carter's battle buddies, Private Ed Faulkner Jr., who suffered from both post-traumatic stress and a drug problem and was discharged from the Army a few months after the battle at Combat Outpost Keating. When Faulkner returned to his parents' home in Burlington, North Carolina, his post-traumatic stress got severe. He would stay up late watching videos of the attack that insurgents had posted online. Not even a year after the attack, Faulkner overdosed on methadone and Xanax. There was no evidence of suicide, but either way, friends felt his death was a result of the horror of his time in battle.
I honestly believe that, yes, he was the ninth victim of Combat Outpost Keating. And I also believe that he won't be the last.
To any of our troops or veterans who are watching and struggling, look at this man. Look at this soldier. Look at this warrior. He's as tough as they come. And if he can find the courage and the strength to not only seek help, but also to speak out about it, to take care of himself and to stay strong, then so can you.
Do you think the Pentagon and our society, America, understand what a crisis this is for hundreds of thousands of troops?
I think the Army understands. The problem is that getting help has to start with the soldier.
A RAND Corporation study in 2008 found that nearly 20% of U.S. military personnel returning from Iraq and Afghanistan suffered from PTSD or depression. Many troops think that that is a conservative estimate, but even if it's not, that would be 500,000 of the 2.5 million who have served in those war zones to the present day. A serious, serious issue.